Hey, everybody. I'm sure by the title you can figure out that I'm going to be talking about Cornell and Deal's Mississippi Mud today. This is one that I've read a lot about on the forums in terms of that people are smoking it, and it's very popular, but I haven't read a lot of reviews or done any research on it, really. I just wanted to kind of have a go at it, sight unseen, and see what I thought about it. On paper, this is one I shouldn't like because it's got a lot of Cavendish in it. And the three main players of this are Cavendish, Perique, and Latakia. From anybody who's followed me for a while, you know I go through phases. And typically I smoke Latakia heavy blends more during the winter. And I'm not really a fan of the heavier Latakia blends because I just can't pick out any nuance from them. It just smells like a campfire after it's been doused. So, on paper, this is just one that shouldn't work for me. When you open the tin, and this is a 2-ounce tin here, vaguely sweet with a lot of Kia in the background. So, and let me see if I can tilt this forward and show you. It's very dark. Just your standard standard ribbon cut, kind of irregularly sized. So I thought, here we go with another Latakia blend, and you know, something that's going to just be overwhelming and just hammer my taste buds. But and that's what I got on the light. Charring light was nothing but Latakia. Smoky, doused campfire flavor, creosote, and that dies away. By the time you get the true light going, that's gone, and there's a sweetness about this. Now, this is a fairly linear pipe tobacco. To my mind, it stays pretty much the same from top to bottom and bowl to bowl. Which I like. But you do get, on every puff, you get this sort of evolution. It starts off as this very sweet, vaguely tart, kind of develops into this really piquant, sharp, perique flavor. Not spicy and not fruity. It's sort of tempered by the Cavendish, I believe. And this is one where all the flavors really marry. And then right at the end, those Latakia blend smokers probably know that the end of that, the end of a puff of Latakia gives that campfire flavor. This promises to have that, and it heads that way. And then right at the end, it's cut off or cut short or tempered by some sweetness from the Cavendish, which prevents it from leaving that campfire smell in your mouth and nostrils. So it almost goes there, and it's reeled back in by the Cavendish. Every time you think it's going to go into that Latakia bomb flavor at the end, and it's a safety net there every time. It is a medium body and a fairly full nicotine strength. I call this a medium strong. It's not something you want to smoke on an empty stomach. It's probably owes a lot of that to the Perique. Also, Cavendish tends to be bitey, at least for me. But this again, I think is saved by the Perique. So the Perique is really the savior of this in terms of strength and flavor profile, and then the Cavendish is what keeps it grounded and keeps it from becoming any old Latakia blend. really good stuff. This is a year rounder for me, even though it's got a lot of key in it. I can certainly handle this during the summer. The flavor is not so powerful as to sort of become cloying to me. So, that is Corn Allen Deal's Mississippi Mud. I think I picked up this 2-ounce tin for a little over $8 from smokingpipes.com. Which also brings me to another point. I don't know if you guys, I want to see if you've found this to be true recently, but I'm foregoing UPS shipping in most cases because I'm getting stuff faster by United States Postal Service for whatever reason. I guess nobody else is using them. Maybe I'm the only one sending packages back and forth. But anyway, let me know what you think in the comments below about Mississippi Mud or anything else that's on your mind. Hope you guys are having a good evening.